¿Quién no recuerda la bandera con la hoja de maple en el medio? Y es que el maple existe prácticamente en todo este país. Hoy en mi diario de viaje, voy de camino a Kelowna, nuestro siguiente destino. Y miren lo que me encontré. Un espejo de color verde turquesa donde las montañas pueden mirarse. Amigos, esto es Diario de Viaje, Canadá. Este camino impresiona por los hermosos lagos que lo bordean. Montañas, árboles, pinos y un río maravilloso. Las vías del tren van en paralelo al río Thompson. Por aquí corre el ferrocarril del Pacífico Canadá y la Canadian National Railway. Aquí no hay camiones de carga que circulen por estos caminos. El traslado de mercancías se realiza por tren. Es una pena que nuestro país hayan acabado con este maravilloso servicio.
I'm Damien.
Damien, pleasure. Ed, or Trailhead Ed, they call me. So, yeah, so we're going to head up about 1,000 meters above Kelowna, see one of the national historic sites in the area. 18 trestles, couple tunnels, some beautiful views.
1,000 meters?
1,000 meters up, yeah.
But by
bicycle. We drive up and then we paddle.
Oh, okay.
We don't have to do the uphill. Nice and flat up there on the railway. So
that's good.
Yeah.
Well, let's go.
Yeah. Here you see some of the signs of the volcanic activity that happened in the area about 35 million years ago.
Apenas en 2003, el ferrocarril de Kettle Valley fue reconocido como un sitio histórico nacional por la Sociedad de Restauración de Puentes del Cañón Maira. Poco después del incendio que dañó 14 de los 18 puentes.
Hombre coyote está echando unos alaridos que se oyen todo el eco.
Do it again.
One of the best points in the canyon for really getting your voice out there. So I love doing these wild echoes. So let's see what we can get here today. Some people say it sounds like a train from the other side when
yeah.
I do that.
Voy a intentar un eco, a ver si me sale.
You're gonna try? There you go.
Yeah.
Come on.
No! No. Hey!
There you go.
No.
There's some.
It's too high for me.
There you go.
Or I need some.
Estoy apurado porque ahí viene un tren. Bueno, todos dicen que hay un tren fantasma en este túnel.
The phantom train.
The ghost train.
The ghost
train. Byron Canyon.
That's
a great sound.
Bueno,
the
ese es el
train of Myra Canyon.
El tren fantasma del Myra Canyon.
Did you hear that? Did you hear the ghost train? That's a lot of fun. So that's 118 meter long, that tunnel behind me. The next one will be 88 meters long.
Para quien le guste el ciclismo de montaña, puede venir al Cañón Mayra. Son muchísimos kilómetros de pista para la bicicleta. Recorrer todo el parque les puede llevar una semana o más. Bellísimo.
So here we are on the tallest trestle, 55 meters high, yep. 220 meters long. And that's where we began, just over there with those multitude of trestles.
You shout in this area.
That's where the echo spot was, and an echo went this way, yeah. Yes.
Pues aquí estamos con Ralph. Ralph is your name.
Rolf.
Again.
Rolf. Rolf. Think about Rudolfo.
Rolf.
Yeah, and with just abbreviation of it, Rolf. Try that. Okay. Rolf. Where we are from, we have it in two directions. We have it in the back and we have it in the front.
Él nos va a enseñar cómo lanzarnos de una tirolesa. Ahora sé lo que se siente ser mosca atrapada. Bueno, amigos, detrás mío pueden ver el lago de Kelowna. Es un lago que mide 90 kilómetros. Listo. No me falles, por favor, cablecito.
El rancho que tiene Rolf es un rancho para familias con niños. Aquí ellos pueden probar sus habilidades físicas y su voluntad. Me hubieran traído cuando era niño.
It was too difficult for me. Right now.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's a very good one.
Bueno, nos dice aquí Rolf. Ah, good. Rodolfo, que vamos a ir a una de sus cabañas para ver el atardecer.
Mayra Canyon, play, stay, and ride.
Yeah, please do.
So, you offer this kind of things for tourists?
Yeah, we do. Play is the adventure park. Yes. Stay where you are.
Yeah.
And ride, they are the horses. You see them down there? A few of them are down there.
Oh, yeah.
Behind the trees.
Kelowna está estratégicamente situado en el corazón del Valle de Okanagan, en la Columbia Británica. Es una de las cuatro ciudades más grandes del valle. El nombre Kelowna proviene de la lengua nativa del Valle de Okanagan y significa oso grizzly.
¿Qué estás viendo ahí?
Hola, amigos. Estoy entrando a los huertos de Davison, Davison Orchards. Parece que la especialidad son manzanas, vean.
Royal Gala, Golden Delicious, Matito, Aurora, Ambrosia.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi there.
I'm Damien.
I'm Tamra. I'm the owner with my husband here at Davison Orchards. Welcome to our farm.
So you're the owner of this
wonderful
place.
Oh, thank you very much.
It's an amazing place, yeah.
Thank you. So we've been farming this area for a long, long time.
Wonderful, Tamra.
Yeah. We make apple jelly, which I was just stalking, which is made with our apple cider. We make caramel apples, we make apple pie, we make apple muffins, we make apple fudge, we dry apples. We do so many things with apples. If you take a peek in the window, you can see they're making apple pie. You can see how many apples are in there. They're just loaded high. This is my husband, Tom.
Welcome.
Right over the winter here, it's a lot of snow?
No, you know, it's kind of interesting because
this is actually the furthest north in North America where tree fruit is grown commercially. So it's quite unique, but that's because of Okanagan Lake.
Yes.
Because the lake is big and deep and it doesn't freeze in the winter. So that's really important for vineyards and orchards.
Of course.
Because when it does get cold, that lake is giving back some of its summer heat and moderating the temperature a little bit, but only very close to the lake. Yeah. As soon as you get away, then it's cold. Our whole farm is really about giving families a chance to experience a little bit about the farm.
Yes.
And have some good times together. And so we have a play area here to climb on the straw bales and, you know, just play.
Yeah.
And that's a lot of fun.
So you have a lot of visitors,
oh, yeah,
families and tourists.
Yeah. Right now in September, then it's pick your own apples. So yeah, they have a chance. I teach them how to pick apples. It's fun.
I'm here.
So come on up here, boys. Look, we have some beautiful apples that are all ready this morning and ready for picking. So we're gonna learn a rhyme that will help you remember how to pick apples the right way the rest of your life. Okay, well, look up at this apple, and we say at the bottom, that's the eye of the apple. So here's the rhyme. Turn the eye to the sky. Can you say that? All right, here we go. One, two, three.
Turn the eye to the sky.
Fabulous. And look what happens to this apple. It doesn't want to come off. But now when I turn the eye to the sky, it comes off so easy. Okay, fill your bags up. Come on, boys.
Well done. There.
To the eye, to the sky.
Ah, that's how you do it.
This apple is bigger than the pumpkin.
Bigger than the pumpkins?
Yeah.
Whoa, that's a big apple.
Siguiendo las instrucciones, turn the eye for the sky. Le voy a venir a piscar manzanas aquí a Davison Orchards.
Nice work, John.
Good. It's good. You want? No? Está deliciosa. Tom, how is called this?
Aurora.
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 It's amazing.
In Canada, we have the Northern Lights, Aurora Borealis, so that's where the name comes from.
And why is your big interest for kids? Why?
Well, we feel it's important to teach kids about agriculture. We want to teach them where their food is grown, because especially children that don't grow up in a rural area or in the farm, they have no idea what a pepper looks like when it's growing on a pepper plant. And that's why we love the tours so much,
yeah,
because they see with their own eyes. They actually see it, and so we get an opportunity to teach them. Cheers. Pie, apple, deep dish apple pie, and of course ice cream.
Está delicioso, de verdad delicioso. Muchísimas gracias. Bueno, amigos, estamos aquí en el Summer Hill Winery y tenemos aquí a un joven, Kenny, que nos va a explicar todo acerca de cómo funciona este lugar.
We were actually established back in 1986. So our first bottle on the Cypress Group. Doda's been winning awards since 92 when we released it. All of our wine goes into our pyramid for a short period of time. And this is where it gets kind of the pyramid energy infused into the wine. And we believe that
the energy of the pyramid.
Yeah, exactly. These are all of the machines that we'd be using for our crush, where we'd be sending them into either the destemmers or getting them organized to the right vats.
Welcome, how are you guys doing? Good to see you.
How are you?
Hi, welcome.
I'm Damien.
Damien, nice to see you guys.
Thank you so much.
You're coming all the way from Mexico?
Yeah.
You know, mi madre was a runner-up Miss Mexico from Ciudad de Mexico.
Wow.
My stepmother.
Yeah.
Runner-up Miss Mexico. Elvira.
Yeah, Elvira.
Elvira, she is a beautiful lady. Whoa.
Beautiful lady.
Yeah. So beautiful. Thank you so much for coming here. We will welcome you with our hearts.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Stephen. Well, let's go check out how we actually time the break.
So with full moon cycles, with the new moon and the no moons, people will come in here each month, and they'll come and actually meditate in however way they'd like to enjoy the pyramid. Ah, Stephen himself really has a way of expressing this one.
Do you want more light? I can open the door, give you more light. A pyramid is a five-sided figure, the floor and the four sides, that has sacred geometry. In a sacred geometry chamber, we and liquids clarify. And we have proven this over a 30-year experiment. It does not make things better or worse. It just brings out the qualities, the essence, I like to say the essence. So we have here at Summer Hill a structure that is second only to the Great Pyramid of Egypt. We are one with nature here. This is an organic, biodynamic, co-venture with nature, the winemaking.
But that's kind of a Summer Hill in a nutshell. You guys would like to come try some of the wine, and we'll see what the finished product tastes like.
Right. Llegó el momento preferido por mí, the tasting room.
We'll start with our sparkling wine that we're most known for.
Sparkling.
Yeah. It's gonna be this bad boy here, our Sipes Brut, the one we've been talking about. It's actually the single most awarded wine in Canada, as it's been winning a golden award every year since it was released back in 92. So you'll get like a nice citrus flavor up front, with a bit of a sweetness, but a bit of a dry finish overall. And it's cool with our wine, because we do that traditional champagne method of yeast in the bottle, you get these very fine bubbles in the bottom of your glass.
Ahora me acordé que tal vez Canal 11 no quiera ver esto.
You can see in the color alone that darker, richer red with a hint of a smoky aroma. The more you swirl it, the more it's going to open up those aromas.
Oof!
Yeah, right?
Wow, it's casi como un perfume. Le voy a dar a probar a nuestro sonidista, a ver qué dice.
But if you're happy to try something very sweet, our Merlot ice wine. And this one is my personal favorite of all the wines.
Está lindo el color, eh?
I always tell people it's like syrup with an alcohol percentage in there.
Uy, esto es una delicia. Este sí no le voy a convidar a mi amigo.
Kelly, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bienvenidos, buenas tardes, mucho gusto. Hola. Carlos Guerrero, bienvenidos a Micho Ungido.
Carlos, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, gracias a usted.
Qué sorpresa y qué buena recepción me tienes. Whatever I want.
Of course, all for you. Gracias. You're in a winery.
Platícame un poco de Mission Hill.
De Mission Hill. Mission Hill es una bodega que surgió hace mucho, empezó en 1966, pero realmente cuando el dueño actual, Anthony von Mandó, la compró en 1981, es cuando empezó un poquito a surgir hacia ver hacia el futuro del Valle de Okanogan.
Pues entonces estamos frente a unas parras de Pinot Noir.
Así es, correcto. Acá es donde sembramos nuestras uvas Pinot Noir. Esta planta es muy especial. Esta planta necesita un poquito ser estresada para producir mejor calidad de fruta.
¿Ah, sí?
Lo que hacemos es...
Entonces déjame sacudirla un poco.
En las condiciones normales climatológicas lo que vamos a encontrar es un poquito de hierba, un poquito de pasto, sí, y las plantas un poquito más cerca. Uh-huh. Entonces lo que pasa es que la planta no encuentra qué comer alrededor porque la hierba está succionando todo eso y se va hacia el suelo. Mientras más hacia el suelo, mejor calidad de uvas tenemos.
Mejor acidez.
Así es. Mientras más joven, produce mucho más frutas, pero menos concentración.
Casi es una pasita, está deliciosa.
Casi es una pasita.
Entonces vamos a la bodega.
Vamos a la bodega, vamos a entrar a nuestra bodega subterránea.
Subterránea.
Así es.
¡Guau! Wow.
Esta es nuestra famosa bodega de vinos subterránea. Y hay algo característico de este lugar, el aroma. Porque acá olemos un poquito de lo que es el vino añejándose, de lo que son las barricas de roble, pero se percibe un poquito como de hongos, como de tierra, porque estamos dentro de Manbushery. Esto es una montaña. Esto está designado que se excavó para estar acá abajo. Está diseñado cuando llueve, todo el agua corre alrededor y entonces hace ese aroma. Eso nos ayuda a mantener una cierta temperatura y una cierta humedad, 14 claro, grados y 75% de humedad.
Hay unas cosas que se insertan en las barricas para uh-huh, probarlo.
Para probar el vino, o tenemos otra que le llamamos thief, que es como ladrón, porque sí, somos los ladrones del
sí,
vino.
Claro.
Te invito a probar una barrica si gustas, vamos Órale, a la otra parte y podemos
vamos
probar.
Vamos a ir de thieves.
Si dejamos este vino fuera por un ratito de tiempo, empezaría a abrir un poquito más y percibimos más fácil estos aromas.
Sí, 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 va cambiando. Dicen que el vino está vivo.
Así
todo el tiempo
es,
está cambiando.
Acá adentro está ganando aromas.
Oye,
te invito a que lo pruebes y a que me digas qué sientes en la boca.
Inmediatamente abarca toda la pared de la boca, el paladar, todo.
Hay una sensación ahí que vas a sentir que todos tus labios, tus cachetes, incluso tu lengua, se van a sentir secos. Vamos a sentir, después de que pasamos el vino, una sensación de... Y esos son taninos.
Tienes razón. Se seca inmediatamente hasta
acá. Se seca toda nuestra boca. Y esos son los famosos taninos que vienen de la uva. Mientras más gruesa sea la piel, por ejemplo, como Cabernet Sauvignon, uh-huh, más taninos. Pinot Noir, más delgada la piel, menos taninos en nuestro vino, menos color en nuestro vino también.
Preparándose para el invierno.
Preparándonos para el invierno. Pronto ya no va a cambiar todas las hojitas, van a estar así amarillas, rojas. Se ve muy bonito y luego la nieve. El invierno.
Estamos dejando la región de Okanagan y vamos rumbo a Vancouver. Me quise detener aquí para que vean cómo las hojas están cambiando de color, lo cual quiere decir que vamos a encontrar un camino maravilloso.
Eric, tell me, where are we?
This is called the Othello Tunnels, like in Shakespeare.
Shakespeare Othello, okay.
And this is in the town of Hope, British Columbia. And the reason why they built this railway was because of silver. They
yes,
found silver in the part of the British Columbia called the Kootenays.
Yeah.
So thousands and thousands of people were going there to get silver. And so they had to build a railway to get supplies there and get the silver back to market.
Si los alcanzan a ver en aquella roca,
están los salmones esperando remontar el río.
What do you think? The salmon is waiting for to feel more energy, or maybe waiting for the light of the morning?
I think probably waiting just to get a bit more energy, because they've traveled, you know, from way out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean,
yeah,
up the Fraser River by Vancouver, just to a little town called Hope here, and then they've turned off that river up to this river called the Coquihalla River. Their journey's not finished, so they're tired,
yeah,
but they have much more to go. Siesta. If the salmon population declines,
yep,
which currently there's problems with water being too warm, and so they don't come up the rivers, or they won't be able to spawn properly.
The bears.
It means there's less food for the bears. And the bears play an important role in the forest. So a bear goes down, takes a salmon out of the water, takes it into the forest, eats only part, a little bit of the salmon, leaves the rest.
Yes.
And all that rich nutrients of the salmon rots into the ground. But that rich nutrients allows the trees to grow big and strong. And of course the trees, they're taking carbon and putting it into the tree,
yeah,
but they're releasing all this beautiful oxygen. So the salmon,
yeah,
are so important to that chain for us to live healthily.
Vaya.
We're fortunate in Canada, you know, we're the second largest country,
yes,
in land size, but our population is so small. You can go get lost,
yeah,
easily. If you don't want to see people, just go north.
Maybe there are more bears than people.
Yeah, there would be more animals than people, for sure.
Yeah.
You know, as a photographer,
yeah,
my passion is landscape and wildlife. And living in Canada, I'm blessed because we have lots of both. So it's wonderful.
Los túneles de Otelo me dejaron con las emociones revueltas. La naturaleza es magnífica y el hombre siempre ha estado ahí para intervenirla. Termino este capítulo con una frase del poeta Pablo Neruda. Si no escalas la montaña, jamás podrás disfrutar del paisaje. Amigos, los espero. Diario de viaje, Canadá.